So this is your theorem number 2. Here the limit is 0 to 2a f of x dx. So when limit is 0 to 2a f of x dx, the limit can be made 0 to a by using this property. This property is proved by using all the three properties of definite integral. One property is a to b f of x dx can be written as minus b to a f of x dx. Then a to b f of x dx is a to b f of t dt. Variables are any letter can be used for denoting the variable. Third property which you are going to use in this is a to b f of x dx can be split as a to c f of x dx plus c to b f of x dx. As usual, the proof of this theorem is by substitution method. Right hand side is a bigger term, so start with the right hand side. Split both the terms. Then do substitution method only in the second part, not in the first. First part will be kept as it is. What will you substitute? 2a minus x will be replaced by a single term t. Then dx will become minus dt. We need to change the limit. When x is 0, when x takes value 0, t takes value a. Then when x takes value a, t also will take value a. So the limit will be 2a to a, f of t minus dt. This minus sign will interchange the upper limit and lower limit. That is by property 1. Then the variable can be expressed by any letter. That is property number 2. Then last property, 0 to a, a to 2a can be combined to 0 to 2a f of x dx. This is the proof of the theorem. So usually they ask you this theorem for 3 marks. Okay. Now comes to the application. What does the application says? The limit is 0 to 2a f of x dx can be made 0 to a by splitting the function into 2 parts. One is the original function. Other is function obtained by replacing x by 2a minus x dx. What is it? This property is applicable only if the limit is starting from 0 to 2a. Suppose I want to integrate 0 to pi, let's say sine square x dx. Then I can make it as 0 to pi by 2. The limit can be changed to half. So probably you are going to apply this property whenever you want to change the limit to half of it. When you do so, the function gets splitted into 2 parts. One part will be sine square x itself. Another part is obtained by replacing x by upper limit minus x. Whose upper limit? The question's upper limit. When you do that, you are going to get 0 to pi by 2 sine square x plus sine square x. And that became 2 times 0 to pi by 2 sine square x. Now sine square x can be integrated by any method. There is a shortcut for also. I'll teach you later how sine square x can be integrated in a short method. Okay, I have taught you yesterday I plus I method for sine square x. You can use so many methods to integrate sine square x. Is this property clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. My first question for today is 0 to pi x sine x upon 1 plus cos square x. This type of problem, x is present. When x is present, what can I do? There are 2 methods for me. I'm going to teach it to both the method. First method is by using the first property. Which property? Using 0 to a f of x dx is equal to 0 to a f of a minus x dx. So I start with I as usual. So I can be replaced, x can be replaced by y minus x everywhere, upper limit minus x. Okay, that became 0 to pi, pi minus x sine 180 minus theta is sine theta because of second quadrant, sine is positive. Cos square, square, we don't have to look at the sign, is always positive. Now we will add 1 and 2. I'll add 1 and 2. When you add 1 and 2, what will happen? 2i is 0 to pi. I'm going to take the limit common for both of them. Numerator x sin x. Here numerator will be pi minus x sin x. I'm cutting down some steps. And the denominator is common for both. Is this clear to everybody? This adding part is clear?
Yes.
Because the denominator is same, numerator can be directly added. When you open the bracket, what will happen? What is the interesting thing that's going to happen? This x sin x and this x sin x gets cancelled. What will be left is only pi sin x. So what you got rid of?
X.
X you got rid of. So this method is method for removing this x. So this is possible only if it is pi. It is not possible with pi by 2. Pi by 2 you have to really check whether it is possible or not. Most of the case no, but maybe some special cases 2x or something it may be possible. If it is 2x it may be possible. Okay, now what I can do? I can use my usual integral, pi is a constant. So remove pi outside. And I can put cos x as t. Okay, I'll write all the substitution methods. Because cos x derivative is present. So put cos x as t. So sin x dx become minus dt. When x is 0, t cos 0 is 1. When x is pi, t is minus 1. So I can write this pi outside. Integral 0, it is 1, minus 1, minus dt upon 1 plus t square. I can interchange the upper limit and lower limit to make it positive. And also I would prefer lower limit to be negative. Smaller number in lower limit. So this became... I'm writing the final answer here. So 2i became pi tan inverse t from minus 1 to 1. That became pi into tan inverse of 1 is pi by 4. Tan inverse of minus 1 is minus pi by 4. So 2 minuses will come. So 2i is pi into pi by 2. Right, pi by 4 plus pi by 4 is pi by 2. So I is pi square by 4. That is my final answer. Is this clear to you? Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you write down, have you written or not written?
Not written.
Writing, sir.
Yeah, write it. Then I'll give you method 2. After you finish writing, you tell me. Here, must write, add 1 and 2. Eh? I don't know. Okay.
Yes.
Are you ready? Can I change the page? Method two. Remove X using 0 to 2a f of x dx equal to 0 to a f of x plus f of 2a minus x. This is a method I'm using. One method of removing x was by adding I plus I method. Another method of removing x is by using this. Okay. This is a little more lesser in step. But don't think every time we can apply. Sometimes you may not be able to integrate. Only that is a problem. So 0 to pi will become 0 to pi by 2. The limit become half. Mandar, when limit become half, what happens to the function?
Sir, first, like, we have to copy the original function.
The original function as it is, the function will become sum of two function. First function will be the original, and other one will be obtained by replacing x by upper limit minus x. Don't take this one. Upper limit of the original function. So become pi minus x, sine pi minus x, and 1 plus cos square pi minus 6. Only problem is, this method can be applied only from 0 to 2a. If it is a to b, you have to use the first method only. So both the method you should know, which is more suitable, you have to check every time. Plus 1 upon cos square x. Now pi minus x. Sine 180 minus theta, sine theta. So there is nothing to explain here. Cos 180 minus theta is minus, but because of square, it will be positive. Now I will write here one more step. 0 to pi by 2, x sine x plus pi minus x sine x upon 1 plus cos square x. Now, I don't think you require my help much here. So, x sine x and x sine x will get cancelled. Pi sine x upon 1 plus cos square x. Now, do the substitution method. Put cos x as t. Sine x dx is minus dt. When x is 0, t is 1. And when x is pi by 2, t is 0. This, there is a change here. So limit became 1 to 0. Pi became outside. Then minus dt upon 1 plus t square. That became pi from 0 to 1. 1 upon 1 plus t square dt. Minus went away by interchanging the upper limit and lower limit. So it became pi into tan inverse t from 0 to 1. So it pi into tan inverse of 1 minus tan inverse of 0. So your answer is pi into pi by 4. And hence answer is pi square by 4. And you will notice that previous answer also was pi square by 4. Understood? Which method you feel better?
Second one.
Second method. But this method's defect is what? This method can be applied only when from 0 to 2a, 0 to pi. Or 0 to 2 pi. It cannot be applied from pi by 4 to pi by 6 like that case. A to B, you cannot apply. A to B, you'll have to use I plus I method. Now we'll do a few questions on this. Where you have to remove x and integrate. I want you to try yourself next problem. Can I change?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Your textbook problem. 0 to pi x sine x into cos raised to 4x, I think. There are two problems. Miscellaneous has got Okay, you write it as cos square x. Doesn't matter, even if it is cos raised to 4x, some other doesn't migrate it. So we have two options to remove this x. One is 0 to 2a method. Which method you would like to do? Use the property. Or use the theorem, you write, not property. 0 to 2a, f of x dx. Is 0 to a, f of x plus f of 2a minus x. So what will happen first case? 0 to pi by 2 it will become. The first part will repeat it. You are doing it with me, no?
Yes.
Wherever x is there, three places there are x. All the three places x will become what?
Pi minus x.
All the three places x will become pi minus x. That is 0 to pi by 2, x sine x into cos square x plus pi minus x sine 180 minus theta sine theta cos 180 minus theta minus cos theta, but because of square here, cos square x. Now sin x cos square x sin x cos square x will get cancelled. This will get cancelled with this. So you will be left with pi times sin x cos square x. Now how to integrate this? Whose derivative is present? Whose derivative is present? Cos x derivative is present. So cos x is t, sin x dx is minus dt. Change the limit. When x takes value 0, t takes value cos 0, which is 1. When x takes value pi by 2, t takes value cos pi by 2, which is 0. So your I will become 1 to 0. Pi outside t square into minus dt. So pi times 0 to 1 t square dt. By using the property, we interchanged. Pi times t cube by 3 from 0 to 1. So your answer is pi into 1 by 3. So that is pi by 3. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
I think one more problem if I do, that will be sufficient there. Anyway, I'll give you a little bit MCQ type of question also. Okay, one more question is there in your test book. That also I'll do. Are you ready?
Yes.
Integral 0 to pi x upon 1 plus sine square x. So you have noticed most of the problem is 0 to pi in this case. I am recording also.